Hi, I'm Angela Martin and welcome to number 67 Scenic Drive in Speewah. Can you hear those birds? This is quite simply a gorgeous little lifestyle property and would be absolutely perfect if you just want peace and quiet, space. You maybe want to have chickens, you possibly want to grow your own veggies, but more importantly, you just want to be. You just want to relax and have no hassles, no dramas, all on a beautiful, low-maintenance, 6-acre property. Let's go in and have a look. This is just going to be beautiful, absolutely beautiful. But please remember, press that little subscribe button and notification bell if you want to find out a bit more fabulous lifestyle properties just like this one. Let's go in and have a look. Going to fall in love with it. What a beautiful entrance into the house area of your property. Now, when we came down here, I don't know if you noticed, these are part of the bromeliad family and they are everywhere. They're air plants, so they just survive on air and a little bit of moisture, and they just, you can dangle them over old wooden logs or, you know, bits of plants, or hang them off your balcony. They really are just absolutely gorgeous. Now, this is fabulous. Entrance, little patio area, hand built rocks, you know, with your hands. So this, I don't know if this works, we are going to get to the inside of the house, but this is just make an absolutely fabulous little Barbie spot. And if you didn't use that one, you could absolutely just put in, you know, your Weber or whatever you wanted to use, but perfect, absolutely just gorgeous undercover living. Now, the house is a Western red cedar and cypress property, and it has got your little balconies that come all the way around. But the first thing you will notice is that it is calm. It is just, I'm home. So we are gonna just take 5 minutes and we're gonna have a walk all the way through the house, and then we're gonna head out into those fabulous low maintenance gardens. I'm just loving the wood. Those windows are silky oak. And the more I look at the house, I think it's cypress. I did say Western red cedar. Looks a bit like Western red cedar, but I think it's cypress. How beautiful is this? Now, again, I mentioned at the beginning about the sense of calm and just utter relaxation. So we've come along a big long driveway. We've got a turning circle so you don't have any problems with your cars. Another little space at the side there that you can just bring all your shopping in. And of course, a patio there where you can just sit and relax. Not that you would have to use that, you could of course, because we've got this fabulous balcony. So let's start with a kitchen. This is gorgeous. Now, you have to think country lifestyle, country kitchen. You know, this is not marble. This has once been a tree with roots and leaves, and it's tactile and it is absolutely gorgeous. The surface is just beautiful. And of course, we've got these little bifold silky oak windows. How cute are they? And you can actually see the little the way that they've been made. That's brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Plenty of cupboards, absolutely plenty of cupboard space. Now under here we've got I don't normally show you under people's cupboards, but there is shelves that run all the way along, so you can get plenty. Again, this would have been a hand built kitchen. Even the doors, look at that, the doors are all handmade, absolutely fabulous. So plenty of natural light, lots of ventilation, We've got a little gas stove here, and again we've got some fly screens and all the windows open. But when you're in this living space, you will have everything open, you have your fans on, and you won't know if you're inside or outside because it just comes in and it's absolutely beautiful. So just have a bit of a breathe in, enjoy that, and then we're going to have a look at each of the rooms. Marveling. Look at that. That's, I'm not going to go on about this, but I'm sort of going to go on about it. Look at how thick that is. That's real love, real tree. That's a real bit of bark. Just absolutely beautiful. So we've got three rooms. Again, rooms can be used for whatever you want in your life. They can all be offices. They can all be bedrooms. They could all be art rooms. The rooms. So we have this one in here, which is off the kitchen, and we have got all the doors open out onto the balcony. We will go in, and the balcony is just brilliant. We've got the wooden floors. The house has got such an organic and, as I said, relaxed, and I mean really relaxed feel. And you've got the wood up here. It's just absolutely gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. And again, our cypress. So big, comfy living area. We've got our wood burning stove, which, believe it or not, in the chilly winter, I know that we live in the wet tropics, but in the winter it does get chilly enough to put some wood in there. You can sit with your PJs on, just nice romantic flames, just brilliant. And then we've got two other rooms. So we've got this one and then the one behind us. Again, all opens up into out under the balcony. Again, more fun. Oh, I think that again, silky oak, absolute fascination with, because it is rare. You can't even buy it, and if you could, it's ridiculously expensive, about $5,000 for a cubic meter. And those boards are, they would be almost, I don't know, maybe 180 or something wide. So that is, that's fabulous. And of course, we had the old style doors and windows again that are so cute. Plenty space. You're going to have the doors open, you're going to be just loving life and relaxing. Another cute, really, really cute room, almost like a double size room. So if you come in here, you know, we've got joyous colors. We've got a VJ ceiling, and again, it opens up. We've got fabulous little windows that are just, again, organic, almost like a Queenslander style. And fabulous, fabulous, fabulous wooden floors. Just absolutely brilliant. So, this, you know, you're going to come home at the end of the day, or maybe when you wake up in the morning, you're not actually even going to leave, because on your 6 acres, you can just be at one with yourself and at one with nature. And speaking of which, we're going to have a quick look at the laundry and the bathroom. And then, as we said, all these lovely natural bits, you take off all your clothes and you jump in. It's a very simple, rustic, but just gorgeous bathroom. We've got some, you know, wooden floor, we've got some tiles. And again, we don't have anyone looking into us. So these windows, they do open and close. I'm not going to stand in the bath, but here we go. You can have them as open or as closed as you like. I'll probably get into trouble for that. Shouldn't have done that. Little cupboard in here just for, you know, for your towels and your little bits and your bobs, little vanity. And this looks like a mirror, but it's not. We actually can go through into the laundry. So, you know, you can almost take your stuff off, get your towel and just, you know, pop it into your laundry basket. Absolutely brilliant. So we're just going to pop a little head around here and have a look at laundry. Now, this has got magic slate floors, love slate, because it's easy to clean. You don't have to worry about it. You can't see the dirt coming in and out the garden. But this doubles up as your laundry plus your separate toilet. So we've got a laundry basin here. Actually, pop a little head back in there so you can see that from that angle. Love all those ceilings and all the old VJ. And then we have got toilet. Now this is a new toilet, almost brand spanking new. And it's got that fabulous little, you know, when you flush, you can actually give your hands a little bit of a wash there. And, you know, super easy for coming in and out. Speaking of which, we're gonna head outside and we're gonna have a walk around those fabulous balconies. You really feel like you're in your own little oasis. Now, we've got the deck this way, and then we've got the deck that way, and then we've got the deck that way, and it's big. Ooh, I don't know how big it is. Okay, let's, there you go. One, two. Okay, so we're about 3 meters wide, and come this way, come this way. Oh, beautiful hammock. So this was at the front of the property where we came in. So that's the other little car spot just in front of the water tank. But you can see it's like a U-shaped balcony. How big are we this way? Okay, bear with me. One, oh, you could just lie in that. Okay, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Keep up. 9, 10, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15, roughly 16 meters of joy looking at that. It's magic. It's yours. It is. Oh, look at those. I think they're called alamandas. Beautiful yellow flowers pretty much all year round. What a glorious, glorious thing to be sitting, relaxing, looking at. And from an orientation point of view, we will quickly go up there as well. Have a look. We've got our water tanks just off to the side. We've got a veggie patch just down over there. Beautiful dam just on the other side of the veggie patch. And the road actually goes, oh, not bananas. The road actually goes from the front and then it splits and it takes us down here to the back of the property where there's a bit of a sort of big clearing, you know, not that you might want to do anything with it. You could put fruit trees on it, but we'll go down and we will have a look. But those bananas are spectacular, absolutely brilliant. And looks like a little chicken coopy pen thing just over there. So this again takes us round to the side. Let me do a quick calculation here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So I get my exercise for the day. How much extra space do you need? But this is just absolutely beautiful. And if we come around here, this is where we came in to undercover area. Now, I'm not quite sure what this is for. Maybe if you've got a little horse or a little pony or something, maybe you could just tether it there while you go in and you make your dinner or your tea. So we're actually going to, in our head, we're just going to start from up there where the road forks. And we're just going to walk down here and then we're going to meet at the veggie patch. Absolutely brilliant. we've got fruit trees sort of dappled throughout the property, but I wanted us to have a look. We've got a little baby shed just behind us, just a little garden shed. But I wanted us to have a look at how the gardens around about the house are open, beautiful and bright and sparkly and sunny, yet you have got all the natural vegetation, you know, like I said, you've got 6 acres, but you have got plenty of space to be able to grow and do and be and titivate, and it's just absolutely magic. And that tree there, I think, is a ponciana, so it should go beautiful bright red at various times of the year. So this is just a little shed, little garden shed. Don't need to open that up, just a little garden shed, and you can see the size of it. But it's good just for popping bits and bobs in. You know, you could put as big a shed up here as you wanted because you have all the space in the world. Well, keep going on about it, you've got 6 acres, and the real fabulous thing is that you can actually walk pretty much everywhere within that 6 acres. So it's flat and for all intents and purposes totally usable. Now we've got water tanks everywhere. Again, you can see the hanging, bromeliads off the trees. They are everywhere, absolutely beautiful. So this road takes us right down, if you look on Google Maps, takes us right down pretty much through the middle of the property. It's about 100 meters wide, and believe it or not, on this side it's about 300, yes, 300 meters from the Scenic Drive roadway down to the back of the property. So just, you know, imagine it going all the way around, meanders all the way down to the bottom. We've got a little baby shed just here again. This could be where we put our chickens. So, you know, you can just put up like a little fence. It's a pretty overgrown, by the looks of things, little chicken area, but it has got fencing on it, and it's got little little door there so you can get in. Little lean-to shed just there, but over here, absolutely magic. I'm just going to meet you over that other side. We're going to have a sneak peek at the back of the house as we go over, and that's a veggie spot just over there. See the beautiful green lawn at the back of the house. I don't know if you can see, but we've got frangipani trees pretty much. Well, we've got one just behind us, which I'll show you, but you can see this little pink flowers starting on them. They smell beautiful. You get the most amazing scent off them. But as we come down to the veggie area, we've actually, we've got things that are literally just growing. That's some mother's herb, apparently very good for your tummy. And then here we've got, look at those flowers. Look at that. That's turmeric or turmeric, depending on which part of the world you're from. And then, of course, you know, fabulous for Indian curries. You get all the lovely little orange roots on it. And then we've got the same in little pots all the way here. And then how fabulous is this? Look, look, look. Your own organic. I'm not sure what that is. Do you know what that is? Do you know what that is? Some sort of vine, maybe a potato vine or something, but just pop your little head over here. This is just absolutely beautiful. We've got herbs in there, we've got weeds in there, which we will not eat, and we've got that cute little spot just at the very back. And if we just look up this way, we've got a paw. Paw. Just imagine all the pawpaws dangling off that. This is just beautiful. Just needs a little bit of TLC, put in whatever you want to eat, put in whatever you want to grow, but it's all there and it's ready. And as I said at the beginning, it's organic. That is the other frangipani. Absolutely brilliant. So we're just going to very quickly head down to the back of the property so that you get a feel for how many sort of open spaces that are. Absolutely brilliant. Before we head down the back, a bit of lock up just so that little animals, we don't share all our little herbs and fruits. But you know what I forgot? I forgot to show you the dam. We have got the most amazing dam just there on the way down to the back of the property. That is just a bit of open land, but you can do probably magical things with it. Just check this out. This is just absolutely brilliant. We've got these again. Look at this. Whoop, this is our little bromeliads that just hang on everything that we've got. Just gorgeous little trees. Just natural. Just natural. But look at this. Look, look. Look, just pop your head round over here. We have our very own dam. Now, if you had, you know, if you had horses or something like that, then you've clearly got a water source for them. You could maybe even put red claw in there, or you could put little fish or little yabbies, but it just, it sparkles, and it just, it feels, I keep saying the word just, because sometimes you get a little bit lost for words when you have such a beautiful natural environment. And if we pop our head down through here, just be careful you don't slip on the bank. You can just see the road that runs from where we've just come to all the way down through there to the bottom of the property, and that's where we're going to head. Throughout your property, Absantheria, they used to be called black boys, and they are native to the region, and especially in Speewah and in Kawa. And they're absolutely fabulous. They just, the grass trees, they just dot the landscape. So we're nearly 300 meters down from the road, and you know, again, we've just got a bit of an opening. So there used to be some, you know, work shed or something down this part of the property. That's all been removed, but we've got nice flat area. We've got grass area over there. We've got flat here. So, like we said at the beginning, if you wanted to put up perhaps another shed, a little cobweb, we've got plenty of space. Again, another little bit of concrete just over here. Some really nice rocks. I don't know if you're into rocks. I love rocks. But it just gives you a sense of how the property actually opens up again. So we've got the beautiful living area at the top. We've got that other driveway that comes down through the centre, natural bushland either side, and then this whole cleared area. As I said, you could put in an orchard. You could use this for your veggies or whatever you want it to be. So this, we get another pawpaw. There you go. The start of your orchard. Look, we've got little pawpaw, little baby pawpaws happening just there. Absolutely fabulous. We're going to head back up to the house. We're going to do a quick wrap up. I really hope you've enjoyed this brilliant little tour of number 67 Scenic Drive in Speewah, and hopefully you have a feel that this is where you could just come, throw off your shoes, sit on your balcony and relax. You could grow your veggies, you could have your chickens, and you literally can just be. I said that at the beginning. And it's really important. You can be reading, or you can use this as your base for your children. This could be if you want to downsize and you just want natural bush, natural environment around you. And you can just tiddle away. That's a little Scottish word, tiddle. You can just tiddle away and make the gardens around about the house whatever you want them to be. Or you could do nothing. That's where you're going to spend your life. Absolutely fabulous. And of course, the location is brilliant. We're almost at the end of a very north through road, so you are not going to get through traffic other than your two or three neighbours that will pass your house, maybe not even every other day. So breathe it all in. Give me a call, Angela Martin, 0403 788 187, or visit the website, AngelaMartin.TV. And please don't forget to press just that little subscribe button, and more importantly, the notification bell, so that you can find out about more fabulous lifestyle properties just like this one.